Welcome to the Low Carb Athlete Podcast, where we focus on discussing topics to help you burn fat, optimize health, and improve performance in life and sports. Transform the whole you from the inside out with the holistic method. Let's dive in. Here's your host, Debbie Potts.
Hey, it's Debbie, and I just wanted to share with you a new device I have discovered. It is called BioSense. It helps me figure out if I am burning fat or carbohydrates for fuel. And this allows me to determine, am I needing to eat more carbs, more fat, whatever works for me, matching my fueling with my training and working on nutritional ketosis, but also metabolic flexibility that some days I want to be out of ketosis. So I can use this device without pricking my finger. It's a breath test, and it is super simple, and you do not need to pay any monthly membership fees. So BioSense helps you determine your fat burn and gives you information on how your diet and exercise impact your ability to metabolize fat and how to get into that fat burning state as well as out of it. So some of you might know that we don't need to be in nutritional ketosis 24/7. We want to be in and out of it. So check out BioSense. Save with our coupon code LOWCARB20 to get $20 off your purchase. LOWCARB20. Head to BioSense, mybiosense.com, and learn more how to start testing and not guessing what fuel source you are burning today. All right, so now that I'm going to add PNOE metabolic testing to my arsenal, I wanted to go over how it works and what do we test and what do we gather? What clues do we collect to help you learn how to burn fat, optimize health, and improve performance? Or really, we should overall be focused on training our future self, learning how to fuel, train, and perform our best for life today, for your events this year, but also your future self. So I am sitting outside with my big hat on. So you might hear some birds, some background noise, but it's so nice out. I got to sit outside and it's cool. And I'm in the shade, so don't worry, because I know I get too much sun. Okay, so how can PNOE help me lose weight? Here we go. For any person to lose weight, he or she needs to get into calorie deficit. A calorie deficit is basically the state where you burn more calories than what you eat. A calorie deficit, any calorie deficit, however, will not work for you. It needs to be the one that works for your individual physiological needs and daily routine. This means that you should not cause your metabolism to slow down, should it be sustainable for your lifestyle and prevent you from feeling sluggish or hungry all the time. If your metabolism drops, you go into that dreaded prolonged weight loss plateau, the state where you keep reducing your food, but your weight is stuck because your body is not burning as many calories as it used to. Moreover, if the plan does not work for your lifestyle, you will quickly give up because of hunger, low energy levels, or no results. So this is what PNOE says, PNOE's research. To avoid all this, five things in your lifestyle you need to have more personalized based on your biology. The macros you consume, the food sources you eat, the time you eat during the day, the type and duration of your exercise you do. I will add my personal experience as a FDM practitioner, nutritional therapy practitioner, and a coach. We also need to add, as you know, my story with chronic stress impacts everything you do. So, tangent here, but remember my story I shared in my book, Life's Not a Race. I was doing quote unquote all the right things, low carb, fasted exercise, bulletproof coffee. I was doing the HIIT training, the strength training, the yoga, doing all what we talk about today. I started doing this back in 2005. I started metabolic testing, training by heart rate, where I burn the most fat. 2007, I started Oh, 2009, I did my USA Triathlon certification course and talked to Bob Siebehor, and he was speaking my language, really talking about what I was always curious about. How are we supposed to burn fat when we keep eating before, during, and after workouts? If I have fat to lose, how am I going to burn the fat on my body? So he was speaking about, lower carb, slower carb fuel as you can, and really waiting till you need to eat. Of course, I took that to the extreme and started not eating barely anything, just eating fat, drinking fat in my coffee, the MCT oil, butter, and maybe collagen back then. And then I was training for Ironmans. I was training for marathons, the 50K trail running races. I was running my own business, teaching fitness classes, training clients, leading run group, spin classes. I was doing everything on top of everything. So I need to always add in here when we talk about what you need to do to lose weight. Yes, it's based on your biology, but also, your genetics, your functional lab testing, because if you have hidden internal sources of chronic stress, you are going to be impacting your hormones, your immune system, your digestion, your liver detoxification, your energy systems. I became insulin resistant, even though I was low carb and exercising, doing fasted exercise. I was making it a stressor that was chronic for my body, for my life, for my genetics. So, if you're more susceptible to too much stress and your body gets overwhelmed easily, more anxiety, you need to really watch this. So, I just want to put that into this podcast article review on PNOE, how we analyze your metabolism with this breath analysis at rest and during exercise, because it is going to help figure out how you should train, how you should eat, and how you should time your fuel. But also, I want to remind you that we need to work on identifying your external sources of chronic stress, because you can't just train right for your results, based on results. You can't just eat the lower carb, time your carbs, prioritize protein. If you have chronic stress, everything else is going to be interrupted. Your body wants to save itself, protect itself. So everything else you do is going to be put on hold, and your body's going to prioritize your safety. So with that, keep that in mind as I talk, because there's so many tangents we can go down. But really remember, chronic stress impacts everything we talk about. So if you don't manage your external stressors, and if you don't identify your hidden sources of internal sources, chronic stress, they're impacting the whole you, impacting all your efforts to burn fat, to improve your performance and your workouts, to improve your recovery, to improve your aging process. Stress impacts everything. Just that's my goal with you, is to teach you that. Okay, so back to my article. PNOE analyzes your metabolism with clinical precision and determines with gold standard accuracy. So we're going to look at how many calories your body burns, so we can prescribe the calories that will induce weight loss without causing hunger and low energy levels. So we want to make sure we don't have the LEA, low energy availability, that I did to myself. I was fasting too much, exercising a ton, burning great fat, but also I wasn't getting enough calories in. Or I wasn't prioritizing protein back then. I was all about fat. No carbs, not really a lot of protein. So how many fats and carbs do you utilize, so we can figure out the optimal breakdown for you of fat, carbs, protein that your body needs for you, so you don't feel hungry. You're not feeling hungry, you're feeling satiated, satisfied, and don't have the cravings. What food sources will help you fortify important areas of your health and maintain satiety during weight loss? I like to say fat loss, and like weight loss. We don't want to lose weight all the time. We want to lose fat weight, and we want to increase muscle weight, lean tissue. The right meal timing to minimize hunger and maintain your energy levels. The exercise program that will prevent your metabolism from declining. So, looking at thyroid health, because if your cortisol is off, as I said many times, your thyroid's usually off. So we want to Look at our whole hormone balance, our whole blood chemistry panel, a full thyroid panel. We need to look at your hormones in a Dutch test, not your blood tests, because remember, that's just a snapshot. The Dutch test is going to be the urine metabolites of your hormones, and it will give us an overview of a somewhat of a 24-hour picture of what's going on with your cortisol, melatonin, and we want to look at your DHA and all that. Okay, so how can PNOE help me live longer and better? So really important here. Oxygen is the molecule of life. The more oxygen you can absorb, the healthier you are. It may make sense intuitively, but there is a simple explanation. For oxygen to enter and to be utilized by your body, there are several physiological processes that need to work together. Your lungs need to inhale it. The heart needs to pump it. Your bloodstream needs to transport it. And then your cells need to absorb it as well. As a result, high oxygen consumption means that all of these physiological processes are in sync. These systems are also linked to clinical conditions that can potentially reduce your quality and duration of life. Specifically, a body whose cells don't absorb oxygen as expected, may be prone to developing diabetes. A heart that doesn't pump oxygen well is a candidate for cardiovascular disease, and lungs that don't absorb oxygen efficiently can indicate respiratory disease as COPD or asthma. So we want to test and look at your GI map or Genova Diagnostics as well to really know what's going on, because asthma can be related to gut health. Okay, PNOE analyzes with gold standard precision how effectively oxygen flows through your heart, lungs, and cells, and identifies which system or systems that may be posing an issue for your health. So we can identify your limiters, or rather, I like to say areas of opportunity. The analysis also determines with clinical accuracy how many calories your body burns, so we can prescribe the calories that will maintain a healthy weight without causing hunger and low energy levels. How many fats and carbs you burn, so we can prescribe the ultimate breakdown among fat, carbs, and protein to maximize cellular health. Ideally, I'd like to test people's food sensitivities and heart rate variability and glucose and ketones occasionally to see if we're on the right track here. Okay, so the food sources that will fortify important areas of your health, such as heart, lung, and cellular health, the right meal timing to minimize hunger and maintain your energy levels, the right exercise program to prevent your metabolism from declining with age, such as the power of oxygen consumption or VO2 max as a gauge of overall health, then in 2016 was declared by the American Heart Association the gold standard indicator of your biological age. The American Heart Association declared VO2 max, which is the maximal oxygen consumption, as a gauge for your overall health in 2016 and the gold standard indicator for biological age. So, I just said that pretty much twice. So, you got that. How can PNOE improve my performance in endurance sports? All right. So, we went over the oxygen as the molecule of performance. We know we can analyze your breath. This gold standard precision, we can analyze how effectively oxygen flows through your heart, lungs, and cells. We can identify your limiter that might be an obstacle in your athletic development. Put that with my functional lab test assessments for getting the full picture is going to be even more the personalized program. All right, so what do we find out with your exercise analysis? Now, this will tell us how many calories your body burns, so we can prescribe the calories that ensure high metabolism, improved recovery ability, and optimal weight. How many fats and carbs do you burn, so we can prescribe the optimal breakdown among fat, carbs, protein during, before, and after your training. The food sources that will fortify important areas of your life, as we talked about, heart, lung, and cellular functions that may be facing problems, again, identifying your imbalances or your limiters or those areas of opportunity to improve performance. So the right meal timing to maximize performance, personalized training zones to maximize the impact of your endurance and interval training, the optimal breakdown among resistance, interval, endurance training that optimize your athletic goal targets to your limitations, blocking oxygen flow throughout your body. So really can learn a lot. Now, we want to figure out what your program is. So if you're training for a race, we want to put that in, say TriDot, if you're doing triathlon, or I've been using Training Peaks for a long time. We'll look at what your A race is, B and C, and then we can figure out your training program leading up to that race. But think about if you can get this data collected before. So if you're in your base training, how more effective your workouts are going to be and how more personalized they will be in the workout description. So we want to look at metabolism. So let's go into that. What is metabolism anyways? Metabolism includes your biological processes that convert fuel from nutrients as fat and carbs into the energy your body needs to survive. Now, I'm not just making this up or saying this from my memory, because that is a limiter for me. So I am reading information that I have from the PNOE coaching program. So we're just talking about metabolism, because I think this ties into why we need to test your metabolism at rest and during exercise. So the energy that we've referred to as calories, this is our metabolism, looking at calories. It's the process through which we burn calories. It's one of the most vital biological processes, since it provides us with the constant supply of energy needed to power our body movements and all functions, keeping us alive as breathing, blood circulation, cell growth, muscle repair, and more. Metabolism differs per person, and that's going to be impacted by our age, our genetics, our exercise habits, nutrition, medication, and of course, your stress, your stressors, external and internal, especially if they're chronic. Chronic isn't good. Acute stress is good and beneficial, but when it becomes chronic, not so good. So why do we want a higher metabolism? You know, I know my thyroid's low. I'm doing some thyroid supporting protocol, but why is your thyroid low? We talked about previous podcasts. We want to speed up our metabolism. Often we have low metabolism or sluggish metabolism due to hormone imbalances, thyroid, liver congestion, gut health. So we want a high metabolism. That means our body is burning more calories than the average person with the same weight, height, weight, and gender. So remember, N equals one, we're not exactly the same. Having a slow metabolism means you're burning fewer calories than the norm. Since weight loss requires a calorie deficit, PNOE says the state of when you eat fewer calories than you burn, having high metabolism is the most powerful protection against obesity. However, besides protecting yourself from weight gain, such as high metabolism, it's associated with faster cellular and muscle tissue repair and other healing processes vital to recovery after training. Therefore, a high metabolism is essential for avoiding injuries. Now, I don't agree that, you know, it's not a calorie is a calorie. It's nutrient-dense calories. It's not, you know, what we used to say is you burn 3,500 calories, you're going to equal, that will equal into 1 pound of body fat loss. If that worked, I would have lost weight training for Ironman. I did Ironmans for so many years, and your body gets used to that training method, and I wouldn't lose anything. So if it was really true, I would be a stick. So really look at your metabolism is more why. I always look at why. Why is it slow? Why is it not fast? Why are you not burning as many calories? Look at your lean body mass to your fat mass. Look at your insulin, blood sugar. So much more to look at. So it's not saying a slower high metabolism that you're going to get a faster metabolism by just changing what you eat, but it's also body composition and stress and your microbiome. But we do want to focus on what we eat, so not trying to burn few more calories than you. We don't want to focus on burning more calories than we're taking in to lose weight. That does not work for most of us. So what can cause slow metabolism? Let's go into that a little bit more. Age. Now, I would say don't blame the aging process. Embrace it. But because this is my big thing. So listen to this. Aging will cause your metabolism to decline. Since the older we get, the harder it is to maintain muscle mass and the less metabolism boosting hormones is growth hormone we secrete. The metabolic decline caused by aging is much less acute than the one nutrition or training can cause. In most cases, it's responsible for a small portion of a person's weight gain. Moreover, despite decline it causes, training exercise can reverse it and maintain your metabolism at healthy levels. So for all those people that I see, hear from, read about, family, friends, as we age, your body composition will change if you don't take ownership and do anything and change how you train. So as I say, don't blame the aging process, embrace it, and change how you eat and change how you train. And then it won't be that big of a deal. Or as obvious. Okay, so nutrition is one of the most powerful drivers of your metabolism. When you reduce the calories you consume and enter into calorie deficit, the state of which you burn more calories than you eat, your body will reduce its metabolic activities in two ways. Let's discuss this. It says, first, it sheds muscle mass. This process occurs since muscles are one of your primary energy reserves that will be tapped into to cover the calorie deficit caused by the food restriction. Second, it makes your remaining muscle mass more economical, causing it to burn fewer calories when moving as walking. This is done by changing the balance of specific hormones that regulate the energy for your cells to burn during movement. Both processes are part of your body's survival mechanism and kick in conserve calories and help you close energy deficit caused by restricting food intake. However, both can be averted with the correct dose and type of exercise. So I really don't want people to think that calorie deficit thing. We want to focus on how to eat to balance your blood sugar so we are avoiding that insulin, and we're going to balance that blood sugar so it doesn't go up. Our blood sugar level shouldn't go up. I think it's more than 30. So from your baseline to your peak, it should be not more than 30, ideally not go over 120 or 130 with the meal, and should come back down to say 70 to 90. Okay. So if you're eating the wrong macronutrient foods, if you're not eating nutrient-dense foods, if you're not focusing on your quality proteins and healthy fats and placing those carbs in based on your workouts, I think that's a big part of it, as well as figuring out your training with your nutrition, but your training is a big part of that weight loss. So what does PNOE say in this article? Training can affect your metabolism in the fastest and most acute way. Although it's a powerful tool for increasing metabolism, overtraining, as I can tell you, can have the opposite effect. The most effective workout type to increase your metabolism is, what do you think? Resistance training. First, it increases your muscle mass, leads to more calorie burn as more active tissue, so it requires more energy. Second, it increases the energy your muscles burn on a per unit basis, meaning that every pound of muscle mass starts to burn more due to positive shift in the hormone balance regulating your cells' energy consumption. So too much training, however, has shown to cause adverse change in hormone balance, reduction of growth hormone secretion, I would say increase in cortisol, also is a big one, that reduces metabolic processes. In this case, metabolic decline and associated decrease in recovery capacity pose a more critical danger for injuries. So I would say focus on strength training, appropriate HIIT training, appropriate endurance training, but what percentage you need to change your schedule is going to depend on your fitness test. So in conclusion, this article says, a metabolic slowdown can pose a severe obstacle in achieving your dream physique and staying in healthy long term, so your longevity process is improved. As a result, one of the most important things to monitor whether your metabolism has slowed down or whether your current fitness and nutrition program are causing it to decline, The PNOE Metabolic Analyzer, our breath analysis, gives you a clinical grade analysis of your metabolism, helping you act early and avoid the pitfalls of the metabolic slowdown. So as I say, you know, take action now. Don't wait until you're broken and having all these struggles and trying to figure out what's going on when you already are really broken. So best to be preventative than wait until you're broken. So the next part of this article, part two, talks about the importance of training zones for health and performance. So let's finish with this. Heart zone training, we've talked about forever. I started doing heart rate training way, way, way back. Some of you probably weren't born yet. 2005, I started doing New Leaf metabolic testing. 2001, I started doing Ironman. So it was 1990-something, I started doing heart zone training with Sally Edwards and helped lead some Danskin training camps in Seattle. And we did heart zone training seminars at our Bellevue Club based on Sally Edwards' program, Heart Zones. So I've worked with heart rate monitors, and I started working with heart rate monitors in my training, doing the Maffetone training back in 2001, 2003. And then I started Mark Allen Elite Team, where we did the Maffetone type of training in our online elite training program for Ironmans in 2003. So I've done heart rate training forever. I started, again, as I said, metabolic testing to figure out where I as an individual should train based on my metabolic exercise assessment in 2005. And then I could really dial in my training program. And then when I started doing Ironmans 2001, I knew how to train, where my heart rate should be, when to add speed work, and what numbers to hit on speed work. And then I started qualifying for Ironman Hawaii pretty much every year. And then some years I decided I don't want to do Ironman Hawaii. I'm exhausted. I'm sick of it. Same with Boston Marathon. I used to qualify all the time. And I didn't appreciate it until I couldn't race anymore because I broke myself down. But heart rate training really helps. Testing it really made a difference. So in PNOE, we figure out your zone. So we have heart rate zones, reflects your metabolic status in different training intensities. So we talk different zones. You hear everyone talking about Peter Attia, Huberman, they're all talking about the zone two training. So what is that? There's heart rate ranges, you know, looking at your beats per minute. Each zone we put it in corresponds to the exercise intensity where your body responds metabolically in a specific way. There's two factors to determine metabolic state in each zones. So PNOE zones uses a fuel mixture, the balance between fats and carbs, and physical traits your body develops when training in this zone. So when training in zone two, your body will burn most fat and enhance the cellular health fat burning capabilities at the fastest rate. So that's why we spend more time in zone two when we're training for endurance events or when we're trying to lose weight. But we combine that with HIIT training and strength training because we know that helps for fat loss and performance. So it's not all or none. It's a combination, but the right combination depends on you. So what's the body's fuel mix? How does it determine our training zones? So the article says, during exercise, your body typically burns a mixture of fat and carbs to release the energy required as calories to move. Fat releases more energy than carbs when burnt. So fat is 9 calories a minute versus 4 calories a minute of carbs. But fat has a slower burning process, making it suitable for low exercise intensities where the rate of energy demand is low. And this is what I've talked about many times when I've given seminars and presentations at conferences, that the fat versus carbs is, think of it as the log burning to feed that fire. If you want slow burning fire, that we actually had a fire pit last weekend in Tucson at my friend's house. We put a big fat log in there, lit some paper, got that big fat log burning, and it burned for a few hours. If we just did the kindling that we used to get it started, we'd have to add that kindling to the fire to keep it burning. So continuous, it burned really fast, but then we'd have to keep replacing it. So think about that as your carb burning is the kindling versus the big fat slow burning log is the fat. So carbs require less time to burn and therefore support higher exercise intensities where the rate of energy demand is larger. So the mix of fats and carbs used by your body is revealed by the breakdown of oxygen and carbon dioxide in your breath. And we measure this through a metabolic device, a metabolic analyzer, as we will use in PNOE. And this will show the difference between fat and carb burn exercise intensity during a treadmill test or bike or whatever mode of exercise equipment you want to use. So the measurement requires you to wear a mask. The information we gain will help us figure out your fuel usage. So we're obtaining that information while you're at rest for the resting test and then this active test. And then we use heart rate monitor. So we're going to use the heart rate as a metric to accurately estimate the body's fuel source, fuel usage, and metabolic status. So what heart rate were you burning this higher percentage of fat? So we do this with metabolic tests, measuring heart rate, and then the fat carb mix we can figure out by correlating mix of fuel mix and heart rate. So we call this getting your personalized training zones. And then I look at this as a coach and metabolic efficiency specialist, that I'll look at where that metabolic crossover point is, where that fat drop goes down all the way and your carbs go up, 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 up. So then we can determine your zones that way. So example is you're burning 30% fat, 70% carbs at 140 heart rate, for example, when running, but then you're only burning 15% fat and 85% carbs at 140 heart rate when cycling. So we want to really look at your running zones are different than your heart rate zone. So we don't say your running is going to be different. Same with swimming. So how many training zones do we use? So as PNOE, we're going to use these five zones. And I know Endure IQ, I did their coaching program and talked to them a lot because they work with S Fuels and Dr. Dan Plews and trying to figure out their metabolic test protocol so I can replicate it somehow. But they won't tell me it. So I'll just kind of do my own version of 4-minute stage and then recovery at the end. But we'll figure out what are your zones. Zone one, training intensities, use warm-up, active recovery. So you're recovering from intense exercise while moving is the example. Zone two training will develop your mitochondrial function, improve your fat burning efficiency. It's highly recommended for long range endurance sports, as well as individuals suffering from metabolic syndrome as type 2 diabetes. We can improve your mitochondrial function here. So we want to support recovery capacity, helping you to recover faster after intense bouts of exercise. So zone three is training. It's designed to strengthen your pulmonary muscles, your heart, and your cardiovascular function. This is ideal to intensity when suffering from lung heart problems, since moderate intensity offers a strong stimulus of your heart and lungs without being exhausted or overly strenuous. Okay, so check with your doctor though. Zone four training helps improve your VO2 max. So we want to kind of do some workouts here to hit those high intensity intervals, and this will help improve lactate shuttling. Lactate is a byproduct of anaerobic metabolism where it can be used to fuel your muscles. As long as your body can clear fatigue byproducts faster than being produced, your exercise intensity remains sustainable. As a result, the greater your lactate shuttling capacity, for the greater your ability to sustain high exercise intensities for longer periods of time. So that's zone four training. And then there's zone five. Zone five will improve your VO2 max and peak power output capability as maximum speed or cycling wattage. That's what I'll be doing tomorrow morning. The exercise intensity is sustainable for 60 to 120 seconds, and this requires you to train at maximum potential. Now, this is what I talked about in a previous podcast I just recorded on fueling, matching your fueling and training. So if you're doing this morning workout, you're trying to do this all out 60 to 120 seconds, so it's 1 to 2 minutes, that's going to be a little more carb dependent. So that's where you want to make sure you're getting dinner the night before. Maybe have a little bit of calories. If you're a female athlete, might perform better. Hit those times. Your power output's a little higher. Numbers, if you had a little pre-workout fuel as some Laird's coffee creamer in your coffee. And then my other idea is having a bar, half a bar as Keon, or the Laird's new bars has mushroom adaptogens in it. And the other one I like is Palo Valley has bar, but just maybe half of it. I don't want to eat a lot. And then I've been trying the HVMN Ketone IQ. So everything I have a discount for is usually low carb athlete is a code you can check out. So why should you care about your training zones? Regardless of age, gender, and fitness level, every person has one or more posing systems posing a limitation to their fitness or health. So as we talk about in everything in health and fitness here on my podcast, it's test and not guess. So if you can test your breath analysis at rest and exercise at different intensities, from not doing anything lying on a mat or table to working out, running or biking, whatever, however test you, highest heart rate you can go, well, we can figure out where your limitation is. Then we can figure out where your areas of opportunity are, and then we can fine tune your workout program based on those results. But we don't know how to identify those limitators, areas of opportunity, sounds more positive, but requires us to focus on your cardio and or interval training or strength training to bring us to balance, to really create the right adaptation so you can improve your performance. So we got to find which area you need to improve more on. For me, we know it's speed work. I can go long distance, I've done it forever, but to go all out for 25, 50 meter in the pool or 100 meters, it's a struggle for me. To go all out in a track and not hold back, it's a struggle. Spin class with power meter, FTP workout, same thing. I know how to go long and pace myself, but to know how to push myself and go into that uncomfortable zone is truly my area of opportunity. So I know that, but I don't know how hard do I need to work to get that benefit into zone 5. So if I can identify what those numbers are for my training zones for me individually, that will help me create a specific training program and then work on my nutrition to match that so I can improve, get fitter, stronger, faster, leaner, all that that I want to do in my next few years, my future self I'm trying to improve. So, you know, working on identifying your areas of opportunity with the metabolic tests, just as I say with the functional lab testing I do on clients, but the PNOE Metabolic Analyzer will help figure that out. It's a gold standard accuracy that's got a lot of research behind it, determining your training zones, and then we create a plan to get the results. So understanding how your body responds metabolically at different levels will help you and I or your coach build a program based on your current picture, snapshot of where you are right now. So your test 6 months, a year ago, doesn't really count. It's where you are right now, and then we meet your body where it's at, figure out what you need to get or focus on to get those results, right? So we want to look at your metabolism, then create a foundational program, maximizing your workout's efficiency, achieving your health and performance goal faster with less effort. So let me know if you have questions. I'll put everything in the show notes of the articles I was talking about today. Again, head to YouTube, hit subscribe so you can get updates of my videos, and I'll do more slide presentations so you can see what I'm talking about. And check out our sponsors on my website, debbiepotts.net. Use the code LowCarbAthlete for HVMN, Ketone IQ, Paleo Valley, LMNT, Electrolyte Mix, Keon. Lots of good stuff so you can learn more. Also, bona fide provisions. I want to do a podcast on why we need to drink bone broth every day, especially after workout in the evening, one cup of bone broth, but the good kind that gets solid gelatinous when you put it in the fridge. So let's figure out how to be the best version of you. Let me know if you have questions. Go to debbiepotts.net to get more info and download those free ebooks on the website. And then if you're interested, schedule a free discovery call with me today.
Thanks for listening to the Low Carb Athlete Podcast. If you have any questions, feedback, or topic suggestions, let us know on Facebook or at debbiepotts.net. You can help us to continue to grow by leaving a review on iTunes. Thanks again, and we'll see you next time.